now they can
That's Palamon.
That's Palamon.
All
right. That's going to be a second time.
Alrighty, so yeah, don't zoom in too much. We don't need to make this bigger. Alright, so take home test tonight, do tomorrow. Tomorrow we start Unit 8. I've mapped out Unit 8. We only have 7 days with Unit 8 before you guys leave for Senior Service Week, and I leave for Junior Spring Trip to Tennessee. And I need you all to know right now that there will be an assignment that you're working on. Not a huge one, but something to keep the skills fresh. Because after next Friday, I'm not going to see you all again until Tuesday, February 21st. We're going to go a whole week and a half without any calculus, and that scares me more than a little bit.
What about the other half? Huh? What about the other half? I get the lead part. Where does the half come from?
So I see you next Friday,
right.
And then I don't see you Saturday, Sunday, because weekend. The
yeah.
whole week, that next weekend, mm-hmm. and then Monday is President's Day, and we have no school.
Mm-hmm. Oh,
ooh. So there's like a
ooh,
week and a half gap.
Thank you.
That's not me, not me. All right. So anyway, let's get back to rocking and rolling here. So I've already collected the quiz. David, thank you for the help with that. Test materials, you have them. Giselle, thank you for the help with that. Tutorials tonight, I'm going to be here until 2 o'clock, so if anybody wants to stop on by, if you have corrections that you want to work on, great, we can do that. If you just need a quiet place to take the test, we can do that. Lots and lots of options of how you want to spend that time. That's going to happen. Also, I noticed yesterday on the assignment you guys turned in, there was this unfortunate thing that happened. What was the differential equation? It said dy dx equals
6x
squared minus x squared y. And here's this is just what happens when it comes to separable differential equations on the AP exam. If you don't separate the variables correctly in the beginning, it doesn't matter what you do next. So popular wrong thing to do looked something like this, like dy equals 6x squared minus x squared y. Dx, that's legal,
yeah.
Right? Here comes the illegal. Dy over y equals 6x squared minus x squared dx. This y, like I think they were like, oh, I'm multiplying. Let me divide by y over here, and let me divide by y over here. You'd actually have to divide everything by y in order to get it over here correctly. And so what happens when you get here, have you separated the variables correctly?
No.
No.
And
I mean,
you are done. There's nothing else you can do to earn a point after that. So if you don't separate the variables correctly, you're done. You cannot get the point for saying that this is the natural log of the absolute value of y. You cannot get the point for saying this is 2x cubed minus 1 third x cubed plus c. All the work you're doing, if you don't correctly separate the variables, goes away. You earn no points for that. Which is why for like half of you, your score on yesterday's homework was like much lower because you lost so many points. Everybody okay? So if you are dissatisfied with that grade, fix it. Get it done by Friday. I don't want you to worry about it tonight, but I wanted to make sure we had the conversation today. Good? All right, so if you guys could go in the problem set packet, this is on pages 17, 18, 19. The goal is for us over the next 25 minutes to work through as many of these multiple choice questions as possible. We are going to do a little bit of a speed dating thing, so I'm going to ask you guys to move in this way. I need on the left here, I need Islay, Celeste, Myra, Steven, and Carmen on the left. So we might need to like move two desks over here. On the right, I want David, Giselle, Louis, Palamon, and Andrew. We need two more desks in the middle.
Oh, wait. Here.
Let's start by feeling good about ourselves.
Yeah.
It's picture day. Let's feel good about ourselves here. So on the left, I lay Celeste, Myra, Carmen, and Steven. It's the ladies' side plus one. No, you're just jealous. Alright, so let's start off by feeling good about ourselves. This is problem number 23. All these multiple choice questions came from the 2016 ABBC international exams. So these are very recent questions from the Pollen Board. There might be some things you're learning for the first time here. All right, the first 2 minutes is silent. You are working on yourself, no help from anybody. And then there'll be time to get help from a partner. Problem number 23, see what you can do. Solo for this first one.
He was doing the wrong one.
Oh, you're doing the wrong one.
He
okay.
Was.
He's very confused. I told him to zoom in.
Yes.
You know, still trying to figure out what that means. One more minute. To help or offer help or get help to finish up this problem. Yes, you're going to need substitution. You are going to have to use substitution, or the angels whisper to you and you know how to integrate that expression. Separating the variables. Do I over y, we get 2x over x squared plus 1?
Mm-hmm.
Right. This goes back to the conversation we're having over there. If you don't separate the variables correctly in the free response, nothing else matters after that. So you got to make sure that you're 100% over here. Integrating on the left, I would hope, is like pretty obvious, pretty natural at this point.
Mm-hmm.
Earn a point over there. Now you're going to have to integrate 2x over x squared plus 1. And the rule of the road way back in the day with integration was the uglier the integrand, the more likely it is substitution is going to be the way to go. So I said let u equal x squared plus 1. Let me take my derivative. du dx is 2x. multiply by dx du equals 2x dx. You get to du over u, and the integral of that is natural log absolute value of u. So the integral on the right is natural log absolute value x squared plus 1 plus c. How many of you guys are good with that? Okay, you get another point for integrating on the right, another point for finding the constant. So at Lewis, at this point, we've made it to the natural log of the absolute value of y equals the natural log of the absolute value of x squared plus 1 plus c. Lewis, what's your next move?
Find Charlie.
You're going to find Charlie. How are you going to do that?
I'm going to plug in the initial.
You're going to use the initial condition, right? So this means that if x is equal to 0, y is equal to 1, plug that in. Natural log of 1 equals natural log of 1 plus c. Oh, that makes me feel good. Right? 0. 0. So c is 0. Using the initial condition, correctly solving for c gets you another point. And so now you've arrived, and it says that the natural log of the absolute value of y equals the natural log of the absolute value of x squared plus 1. Karin, where do you want to go from there?
Oh, you would just exponentiate?
That's the word. You're going to exponentiate both sides because we see the ln. We know that those guys are inverses of each other. And that's going to cancel out. Those are going to cancel out. The absolute value of y equals the absolute value of x squared plus 1. Myra, where are we going to go from here?
Go back to the initial condition to see if it's negative or positive.
Almost. We're almost at that step. There's something that needs to happen first. Yeah, but the thing is, you've got to get rid of the absolute value bars, the ones over here. So what you're saying is that y is either the positive or the negative of the absolute value of x squared plus 1. Now you go back to the initial condition and you say, oh, I need, when I plug in x equals 0, for y to be equal to positive 1. That drives your choice. So it's clearly going to be the positive version. And you might say y is equal to the absolute value of x squared plus 1. And then you look at your answer choices, and it's not there. Why isn't it there? I'm going to get some hands on this. Why isn't it there? I'm pretty sure what one you would choose. Right, I would hope everyone's going to pick B. Mm-hmm. But why are the absolute value bars aren't there, David?
Because it has to be plus 3. One for it, too.
We've got the absolute value of x squared plus 1, but they're saying that the answer is y equals x squared plus 1. They have gotten rid of the absolute value bars. Why is that legal? Stephen, why is it legal?
Because earlier you used the plus or minus, that basically cancels out the absolute value bars.
Not true. Not true. There's a reason that you don't need the absolute value bars, and it has to do with what you're making the absolute value of. Lewis, what do you say?
Because x squared, it doesn't matter if the x is negative, it will be positive.
One more time. Look at what you're taking the absolute value of. One more time, Lewis.
X squared plus. So since the square, you doesn't matter if it's negative 1, it will still be 1.
Right. Think about any x value that you're going to plug in here. Once you square it, you get either 0 or positive, and then you add 1, this part in here is always positive. So those absolute value bars have nothing to do. Now, free response, this is a perfectly acceptable answer, but they might mess you up by like not putting the absolute value bars over here, and you might be like, oh, what's going on? Is everybody okay? Mm-hmm. All right, good. Okay, rotate this side, go down 1 seat that way. All right. Next one, we're going over to question number 7 on page 19. All right, 2 minutes of independent work time starts right now. 2 minutes. Question number 7. Thank you. this one is calculator inactive. Which really surprised me because usually Euler's method shows up in the calculator active section. Usually. But if you start working with the numbers, it's hopefully not too bad. Polymode, quick question for you. What's your step size here?
0.2.
0.2. How'd you get that?
Because it's saying that it's going from 2 to 2.4, and it's saying it's moving in increment in two total movements.
Perfect. You're going from x equals 2, this is your initial condition, over to x equals 2.4. You have a gap of 0.4, two steps of equal size, so 0.4 divided by 2 is 0.2. Some help or give some help. Tangent line has this form, negative 0.5 times x minus 2 plus 3. So how am I going to get f of 2.2? F of 2.2 is approximately what I get from negative 0.5 times 0.2 plus 3. Is that 2.9?
Yes.
Okay, so that means f of 2.2 is approximately 2.9. Great, but I need to get to f of 2.4. So now you're going to ask the question, what's f prime of 2.2? You get that from the table. So L2 is negative 0.3 x minus 2.2 plus 2.9. So f of 2.4 is approximately negative 0.3. The difference here is 0.2 again, plus 2.9. I think it's a little ugly that they expect you to multiply 3/10 and 2/10 in 12th grade. What are they thinking? And you're going to get 2.84, which is C. How many of you guys honestly hit C? Yeah. Okay. For the most part, feeling pretty good. Rotate. Rotate. New topic coming your way.
No, no.
No.
Oh, here it comes.
What?
Number 13. Number 13, and I'm going to give you guys the full 2 minutes to talk with your partner on this one.
Oh, we
can
talk.
Oh, yeah.
Wait, what?
Oh, sorry.
But only with your partner.
Okay, if x equals 0, this looks undefined. Yeah.
You could have a 0.
Yeah. So then I think it can't be B. Because like if x equals 0, then there would be like 0 in the denominator.
Trying to the bottom. Is it B?
I know it's not.
No, but B.
It's not B.
Yeah, I think it can't be.
It is this one, one, one?
Can you
be B? It can't be C, it can't be E.
It's not B. It's not B.
Where the X and Y?
Everybody seems to be going through some sort of process of elimination here.
Mm-hmm.
Right, which is exactly what I would do. I would never be able to just like, oh, here's the slope field. What's the differential equation? Nope. Nope. Here's the slope field. Which one could it be? David, give me a place to start. What did you do? I don't want the final answer, but what did you do?
I started with 1-1.
You started at 1-1. This looks to be, oh no, wait, where's 1-1?
The second tick mark.
This guy here?
No, second.
Right, and so like they're being mean here. Not only is it a slope field, they haven't really given you a scale that you can like really read. You are making some edumacated guesses here. And so this looks like it's the point 1, 1. And at 1, 1, the slope is 0. So based on that, David, what do you know for sure?
It can't be D or E.
It can't be D, because if you plug in one for X and one for Y, you're not getting 0. Not D, also not E. Nice. What other ones have we gotten rid of and why? Celeste.
I got rid of B and C.
Tell me why.
Because at X equals 0, it looks undefined. It looks like there's a vertical.
Now, this is where like I get things all screwed up in my head here. X equals 0 is that the x-axis or the y-axis? For real, right? X equals 0, that's all the points here. And what do we notice? There are no tangent lines here. There are no tangent lines. So at x equals 0, dy dx is undefined. So let's see, where would I get undefined for x equals 0? If X is in the denominator, and that's where I'm gonna go with A, not B or not C. Mostly okay? All right, rotate.
Oh, by the way.
91.
Oh, no.
You knew it was coming.
Oh, you just
91. This is definitely a BC only kind of question, and you can have 2 minutes to talk to your partner.
We're question 91.
I hope to someday write questions for the College Board. They're doing a really good job in this international exam, asking questions in new ways. Andrew, get a question for you. Brace yourself, son. Why is this logistic growth? Yeah, I knew. Okay, good. Now that we've recognized that it's logistic differential because you said it, what in the problem are you reading that is screaming it's logistic growth? There's a limiting capacity. And why is there a limiting capacity? What's the situation? A rumor spreading through a school, right? Is it a rumor?
Yes.
So there's a rumor spreading through a school. There's only so many people that are going to be able to hear this rumor. There's even less of them that care about this particular rumor. So what I hope is as soon as you saw logistic differential equation, you're hopefully your brain is pulling up, oh, it's K times P times L minus P. And any easy ones to get rid of?
the A.
None of them. They're all in the form, right? You know that L is 500. Great. Question I might ask you, at what point is the rumor spreading fastest? At what point is the rumor spreading fastest? This is one you just need to know.
250.
When the number of people is 250, when you're halfway to your limiting capacity, that's when it spreads the fastest. At noon, 50 of the school's 500 students have heard the rumor. And I heard Palamon kind of ask the question, like, at noon, are we counting that as T equals zero? Maybe. There is nothing in this differential equation that has anything to do with time. Everything is about population, not time. The other piece is that P is increasing at a rate of 20 students per hour. That's the key to this problem. That means that dP dt is equal to 20 when P equals 50. Right, when the number of people that's heard the rumor is 50, no matter what you're referring to it as the time, dP dt is going to be 20, so your setup should be 20 equals k times p times 500 minus 50. And if, right now, it's just not even a calculus question, we're just plugging in, and I think if all goes well, you get 20 equals, that's 450, 22,500 k.
1125.
Okay, sounds good. 1 over 1125.
A.
So that's going to be A. How many guys actually get A? Okay, 1, 2, 3. I've never seen the College Board ask a logistic differential equation this way. I would say you're in a good place with logistic differential equation if you saw this and you're like, this is what the equation is going to look like. Or the other one, remember it was what, K times P and
one.
Then...
P
over L, because it's your population divided by the limiting amount, because you needed the right ratio to happen here. All right, I don't even need you to move on this one. I want you to stay right where you are. We're going to have a conversation about number 17. 14. 14, very first question. Blew my mind. I swear, if I was a teacher of the 2016 international community, I would have been a little upset. I wasn't even 100% sure what they were asking with this question when I read it.
What?
Okay, all right, for like the first 5 seconds. You know, then like smarticle particles kicked in.
Can I ask them? Give me
some. Read it, have a quick conversation.
I need some.
Excuse you, question.
Dy dx equals e to the x squared with the initial condition f of 0 is equal to 2.
Okay.
Got a differential equation. Is it separable?
Mm-hmm. Yeah.
I think so.
Okay.
So you can say dy equals e to the x squared dx, and you could try integrating, and I'll tell you the problem is going to be integrating on the right. Maybe I'm thinking substitution, right? If I say u is equal to x squared, well then du is 2x. It's not in there at all. Totally stuck. Look at their answer choices. Wait a second. Look at the answer choices. What are they actually asking? What are they using here?
They're leaving it like it is.
They're leaving it like it is. There's something specific that they're using here. I know the bell just rang. What they're using is the fundamental theorem of calculus. If you're like, what? F of b equals f of a plus the integral from a to b of f of x dx. What they're saying is you want to know the function. You want to know f of x. What's f of a? 2, that's your starting point, plus the integral from a to b, 0, my starting value, to x, my ending value of f of x dx. We've not done anything in the world of differential equations that's like this one. So it should be D, right? There's not even anything to do. You either see it or you don't see it. I bet most of you would have started this way and then hit the wall with integration by substitution. So my advice is, look at your answer choices. Look at what they're really asking for. Okay, see you guys later. Be safe. Stay away from the boys. I'm not going to say a darn thing about that. Hey, somebody left me their test.